Happy watching!
Hey, this is Chetna, and you're watching ChetChat, the largest online career and education talk show. So we've spoken a lot on this channel about scholarships and admissions, and also about how to study and make notes. But the question is, what truly makes a successful student? What is that secret sauce that helps a student succeed in all areas, seemingly effortlessly? So today, I'm going to give you the top 5 ideas for college students to help make you a successful student. And there's also a bonus tip coming along at the end. So stay tuned. And also press that subscribe button and the bell icon right next to it for your notifications. And give this video a thumbs up if you like our work. Now the top 5 ideas, I like to call them SNICK, because they're going to help you just SNICK past your competitors. And idea number 1 is S for start something. Now, I think you should start something new in college. You could start a blog or a comedy group, a conference, a club, or even a business. So I think there are 3 big reasons why you need to start something in college this year. The first is that you leave a legacy behind. It is very rewarding to know that something that you've started becomes part of the college culture and is followed by the future batches. The second reason you want to start something is because you learn project management. Managing people and implementing ideas is no small feat. And if you can learn this in college itself, it'll give you a head start into your first job or internship. And the third big reason is because you never know what comes out of it. Some of the biggest and most successful companies were established back in college dorm rooms. So go right ahead and start something right this year. So you're thinking, how do I just suddenly start something in my college dorm when I don't even have the skills to do it? So one of the ways to acquire the skills is by volunteering. You could volunteer at an NGO. And another opportunity that comes to mind is the Board of Young Leaders program by Eat My News. Once you're part of this thriving community, you get a lot of guidance and mentorship. You also get to work in different fields like marketing, content, and HR. And this not only helps you networking with people and acquiring the skills that you need to, but it also helps you decide exactly which of these fields you'd like to pursue in your career going forward. So I'm putting a link in the description box below, and you want to check that out as soon as you finish watching the video. Idea number 2 is N for networking. Networking with your professors and with your peers. Now, I suggest you build a relationship with a professor you deeply respect. And a strong relationship is built by talking to them after college or after class and discussing research and internship assignments and opportunities and the industry at large. Now, just like a sports person needs a coach in order to compete professionally, you need a mentor to help you become successful. And a professor could be a great mentor that could completely change the course of your entire career. And the efforts that you put in could give you payoffs in the form of personalized letters of recommendations, possible introductions to potential employers, interesting research and consulting assignments, and great advice and mentoring and guidance. Now, the second part of networking is networking with your peers. I know you love your bunch of friends, and back in college, I just wanted to hang out only with my friends. And I totally understand that, because college is a time when long-lasting friendships are built. But I suggest making friends and reaching out to people who are outside of your comfort zone. So have one conversation every day with one peer from a different department. And you know what? You have no idea where that one single conversation could lead you to. Idea number 3 is I for internships. Now, college is the time for you to find out what you really like doing and what you don't, what you're really good at and what you're not so good at. And the best way to find that out is to go and do it yourself. So take up a lot of jobs and internships on campus, outside campus, and the places where you can find them are on online portals, on your college career fair, or even through references given by your professor. Now, I suggest here that you should try out a number of different things. Say perhaps one vacation, you work for a startup. Another time, work for a large company. A third time, maybe do a research project or a consulting assignment under the professor or with a smallish consulting company. Another time, you could volunteer with an NGO. But experimentation is the key here. Idea number four is C for conferences. I wish I could go back to college and attend some of those amazing conferences. They're not only fun and great learning, but they give you an opportunity to network with like-minded people from around the world. One such conference that several students have recommended to me, and I want to share it with you, is called the Youth Leadership Conference. And I'm putting a link in the description box. You want to check up where this takes place in your city and go and attend it. In addition, I want you to grab every opportunity that allows you to speak to large groups of people. This could either be at a conference or a TEDx event that your college is hosting or a college festival or an MUN conference or anything that allows you to do public speaking and to overcome the fear of public speaking right now while you're still at college. And idea number five is K for keep learning. College is the best time for you to acquire practical skills. I know it's important to study and work hard and do all those online courses for curriculum-based work. But it's equally important for you to attend some offline courses which involve you learning some personal skills. One interesting platform that comes to mind is MindGrad. I'm putting a link for you at the bottom, but they have some very interesting offline courses like life design, personal branding, digital marketing, or interviewing skills, emotional intelligence, and several others. So take that link and go check it out once you finish watching this video. Another way for you to keep up your learning apart from what you're learning on the curriculum is by listening to podcasts and by reading books across the spectrum on various different topics. And now for your bonus tip. I strongly recommend that you go on an adventure and do at least one backpacking trip on a shoestring budget so you learn how to survive in an unfamiliar environment. Another thing that you could take up is a study abroad trip or even a semester abroad if you have that opportunity. So remember, college is a very special time, so make the most of it. And I wish you the best. Keep watching, subscribe to the channel, press that bell icon, give me a thumbs up on this video, and happy watching.